from the bottom of my heart. And thanks to all of you to show your presence here. So now today, as today's public championship competition, you all know. And now right now, there is only one thing that will be circulating in your mind as well as in your body, that after some time, I will deliver my speech. Then will my speech be appreciated by the entire audience or not? Will Ruben sir give me trophy or not? Yes or no?
Yes.
But do you know what a successful man thinks if he has to deliver his speech? He thinks that no matter what happens, if I have prepared my speech at home, then definitely I will be able to deliver a speech at least for 5 minutes in front of all of you. And this is the very first common trait which you can find in every successful person. And do you know, the persons whom you call successful, no matter in what circumstance they are sustaining their life, no matter, they will not run away from the ultimate goal ever. And to justify my this statement, I want to put the example of Ira Singhal. Do you know who is Ira Singhal?
IAS officer.
Yes, she is the first Indian disabled woman who cracked the UPSC exam in her very first attempt. But now, see her passion. Ira Singhal is suffering from scoliosis, and it is the condition of the spine where it turns sideways. And owing to this, she has difficulty in moving her arms. And this condition also debars her from being eligible to be an IAS officer. And even though she had cracked the exam in her very first attempt, but she was forced to deny the position on the grounds of her physical disability. And after this happening, Ira goes into the depression. And it is not true that she is enjoying her failures and she will not go into that depression. She goes into that depression, but she comes out of depression very soon. And this is the second most common trait which you can see in any successful person. And after this happening, Ira had only two options. First one was just cry and cry throughout the life. And second is hold her goal very firmly and fight for her rights. And Ira has done the same thing. She fought her case very enthusiastically and at the Central Administrative Tribunal. And at that time, all the people were seeing and noticing that if she can wander, if to fight for the case, she can wander at the court, then why she cannot roam district to district for Indian Administrative Service? And then, in this way, after a long struggle, she